All right, welcome back. It's 6:44 right now, and we are headed back to the North Florida Wildlife Center.
Apparently.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite little segments that we do. You know, I love heading out there to kind of get to see all the array of different animals, endangered animals that they have.
So who do we meet this time?
A giant anteater.
Like, when you say giant,
like big boy.
12 feet by 300 pounds, or like this big?
No, he's big. He's
okay. bigger than that.
He's a big boy. His name's Bumi. Oh. He's a cool.
That sounds like a kangaroo name. Yeah. Bumi.
Bumi?
Like, I don't know why, but
Bumi.
Yeah, maybe that's why I picture a kangaroo.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and take a look at my discovery.
This is King Bumi, as he's popularly known. He is our ambassador giant anteater. This is certainly a giant anteater. These guys, unfortunately, are an endangered species. They're native to Central and South America. They are extinct in several countries that they're normally native to. We are checking out his impressive 2-foot tongue, eating his favorite treat, hard-boiled eggs. Normally in the wild, these guys eat almost exclusively ants and termites, which they use that super long tongue to get to, and they use these super powerful claws to rip deep into those super concrete hard termite and ant mounds. And what we're doing here is part of our anteater encounter. We're one of very few facilities on the planet that allows visitors to interact with a giant anteater in this way, and it's an incredibly unique opportunity.
Yeah, no kidding. So you kind of touched on it, but just talk about how unique it is. You talk about it being an incredible opportunity. I mean, really, this is one of a kind, right, for people in this area to be able to experience.
Absolutely, and in the world. These are very, very rare and endangered animals, and to have one working in this way alongside his trainers like this as an ambassador is very rare.
Yeah.
Bumi is sexually mature now, so we're working on getting him a girlfriend, and he's very excited for the opportunity to breed one day soon, hopefully.
Understandable, and I think we have established he's not so much of a morning person, so.
That is correct.
He's much like many of us.
Late teenager, so late riser, as I'm sure we all know.
Totally. Yeah. So off he went. That's okay.
Yes.
We understand.
He'll be back.
Yes, I'm sure once he smells the eggs.
That's right.
Of course.
That's right.
So, but just to kind of continue on to that, though, it's so cool to be able to have him here, to be able to have these exhibits and stuff. But he also has his own drink after him as well, right? So can you talk to us about
that? That's right. So we recently collabed with local brewery Ology to create Bumi's first brew.
Yeah.
It was a wonderful fundraiser and collaboration. This was a limited time beer. It was so enjoyed by all, and it's really a unique opportunity and a really cool thing that we did with a local supporter, like with Ology. So
totally.
It was really great.
That's awesome. And so you said also you're hoping to get Bumi a girlfriend.
That is correct. We'll be expanding his habitat to double the size that it is now. He is an endangered species, so very important that we help maintain the genetic diversity of giant anteaters, and we'll be getting him a girlfriend from a sanctuary or a zoo sometime soon.
How cool
okay.
is he?
I was amazed that he was so okay with just getting scratched and petted.
Right.
He was grabbing his claws, he was okay, I'm good.
Whatever.
Did you pet him? Were you?
No, I always try to respect, you know, whatever is going, like, if I'm allowed to or if I'm not, you know. I wanted to. His fur was crazy, though.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering.
It's like wiry. Yeah, so I didn't pet him, but like he rubbed up against me so I could feel it a little bit. Yeah, he was very wiry, yeah. But really interesting, the take on the tongue thing, I was like, oh my gosh, that thing is so long.
Think about it, he's got to get into the holes in the ground to get to the insects. That's
ants.
What they eat. So
it was pretty gnarly
evolution,
stuff.
Evolution,
right. So, but also on top of all of that cool stuff they've got going on right now at the North Florida Wildlife Center, they're also getting ready next month here in just a couple weeks, September 7th and 8th. They're celebrating their 4-year anniversary.
Okay.
So they're going to have all kinds of encounters. So obviously you guys just saw the encounter that I had with Bumi. People can go and have that encounter any day of the week, which
is cool. I surely wouldn't want to be having that encounter in the wild.
Oh, yeah.
If I saw that thing just walking.
Yeah, I'd be screaming.
Somewhere. Oh my God.
Yeah, he was pretty cool though. I'll give it to him for that.
Okay.
A cool guy. So you guys will have to check that out. And we'll also put all the information about the 4-year anniversary on our website after
Very
the show
cool
as
stuff.
Well, so everybody can check it out.